Hi, my name is Chef Hemuy de Baron. We're doing a cooking demo today brought to you by Restance and East Cafe at Restance Makati, second floor. This is part of their ongoing wellness promotion campaign here at Restance. And we're going to be doing healthy, good food that is both nutritious and delicious. We're not talking about boring, bland food that is under seasoned and it's just boiled, but we're doing exciting food that you can do in the comforts of your own home. We're going to be using some of the Restance products from home, so do check it out and check out the recipes at our Instagram page. Okay, we're gonna start. So the first thing you want to do is cook your rice. The rice will cook about 30-40 minutes. This is the black rice. My suggestion is to soak it first for at least 30 minutes to an hour, just so that it breaks down faster. So, but it will cook about 20 minutes. Tapos the ano is for 1 cup of the brown black rice, it's 2 cups of water. So after cooking that, yola, we have a cooked rice here. That's our black rice. For our dressing, I have the sesame oil and also the Japanese soy sauce. We're going to whisk that together along with the rice vinegar. Then you're just going to whisk that. This is a serving for one lang. Of course you can multiply this by 4. We're going to post the recipes also at our Instagram page. So you can check that out for the exact recipes. And then I have a bit of coconut cream here because I want some island flavor to our dressing. So we're gonna whisk that also in. So that's it, 4 ingredients. Soy sauce, sesame oil, rice vinegar, and our coconut milk. Okay, for the other parts of our bowl, again, we're gonna use avocado, cucumber, edamame, all good stuff for you, all very healthy. And with this, you're not really cooking anything, you're just preparing stuff. And we're gonna be putting it together. So make sure your salmon, you can also use tuna if you prefer that. That will work too. So you put your salmon with your dressing. The dressing also will be the sauce of the other things, so that will tie it up all together. So mix that, and then I'm gonna put my spring onions in there. A bit of the onions as well. You want a punch of the onion there. Set this aside. And I have some, for more protein, I have a boiled egg here, soft boiled egg. Now it's assembly time. All you need to cook right here is the rice. Everything else, just make sure it's fresh and it's good. Okay, we got all our toppings ready, so it's basically assembly. Our salmon. Now I'll marinate the salmon for a good 3 minutes, and you're ready to go. So that's the first thing you want to put in. Put it on one side. So this is about 200 grams of salmon. That's one good enough for one portion. About 150 to 200 is a good portion. Yeah, very healthy. And then we're gonna start putting in our vegetables and garnishes. So the avocado is gonna provide super healthy and creaminess also for the dish. I like the cucumbers because it gives it a crunch and a freshness. Eggs, and that's really nice when you mash it with the rice. A bit of togarashi if you want it spicy. Furikake is a Japanese flavored like umami bomb. I like to put that in the rice. It gives it crunch and texture. just something fun. And then I have some nori, also flavor, right there. And then some baby radish next to it. And then you have extra sauce, you're gonna drizzle the dressing that we made with the coconut. And last, I like edamame. Edamame is really good for you, very high in fiber. And very nutritious, very low calorie, provides lots of protein in low calorie form. So this is actually a high protein bowl. You could lessen your rice so that it's not as high in carbs. So there we have it. And lastly, just a touch of toasted coconut to round off our salmon poke bowl. And our dressing. Dress the vegetables, because the vegetables and the frano doesn't have much seasoning. So it's going to be seasoned with our dressing. There we have it again, our salmon poke bowl. For our next recipe, we're going Mediterranean. Of course, the salmon poke bowl is sort of Pan-Asian, Hawaiian, served with the coconut. This one, we're going Mediterranean, also very healthy. It's actually a healthy dish in itself already, falafels. But falafels are mostly deep fried. So we're gonna make it even healthier by using Russell Hobbs air fryer here, the digital air fryer. We're gonna cook it here. Not only that, we're gonna cook the mushrooms, the shimeji mushrooms in there too. So we're gonna make a bowl out of it. We're gonna make a sauce. We're gonna have a grain. Now, you can use rice, you can use adlai. Today we're using quinoa. Quinoa is very easy to use. So this is what it looks like. It's an Asian grain, high in protein, much lower carbs than rice. So this is a good alternative for rice eating. We're also using some chickpeas, some beautiful herbs and spices, some fresh, some dried. So it's gonna be flavor packed and very good for your body. Okay, we're going to start with the shimeji mushroom. We're going to cook that in the air fryer also. Season it with salt, a bit of pepper, and a bit of paprika. Toss that. And then we're going to put a bit of olive oil. Now, if you're air frying anything, it still needs a bit of oil to start that process. Or else it's not going to brown properly. And you need a bit of moisture in there. So kind of massage the salt and the spices in our shimeji mushroom in oil. So we're going to use this Russell Hobbs Brooklyn air fryer, all digital. We're going to put it in. We're going to turn it on, set the temperature at 190, and then we're going to do 15 minutes. And then you're going to open. So essentially it's a roasted mushroom, and mushrooms are beautiful roasted. It's gonna bring out very deep, earthy flavors. Oops. Okay. And then just press start, and it's gonna start. Okay, so our mushrooms are cooking here in the air fryer, this Russell Hobbs air fryer. In our induction stove, we're gonna be cooking our quinoa. We're using this chef series of Becca, beautiful stainless cooking wok and a saucepan. So for this, you just need to cook it with 2 cups of water for every cup of quinoa. 15-20 minutes covered, and then shut it down so that it steams. And after 20 minutes, this is what you have. Okay, so fluff it a bit with the fork so that it doesn't stick together, and that could wait for the bowl. You can just pop it in the oven or keep it in the warm cover. So we're gonna start our falafel. Now falafels are traditionally chickpeas or garbanzo. So for now we're gonna be using canned chickpeas because it's just easier. If you wanna use dry, go ahead. But you have to soak that at least 8-12 hours or overnight and then boil it so that it becomes ready for use. So we've taken out the skin of the garbanzos. So this is about one can. We're gonna season that with salt. About, I'd say, siguro mga a quarter of a teaspoon. That's the thing with carbs, that it's thirsty for seasoning. It needs a bit of seasonings for the flavors to come out. Cumin, very essential. Paprika, also essential. I have some already chopped flat leaf parsley and cilantro. Those are super essential to the falafel. And then some onions. And then all-purpose flour. The flour is just to bind it. And then baking soda to neutralize falafel. Now we're gonna give this a quick process. Okay, after a while, we're gonna give it a good mix. Just making sure that the flour and the baking soda is. So that's the texture that we want. Here's your falafel. Now we're gonna start to form them. I'm gonna crust it with it. Since it's not deep fried, you're gonna lose a bit of the texture. So to compensate, we're gonna roll it in a bit of sesame seeds to get that crunch, plus the flavor of sesame seeds. For this, you can just use your hands. I'm gonna use this chopping board and just leave them here. Now, I like to form my falafels in a disc so that I don't cook it so long. Others kasi make balls out of it. That's okay also, but the thing with the ball, it takes longer to cook and sometimes it's uneven. So, shape it like a ball, just like this size. And then, all you need to do is flatten it. So there, it doesn't even break apart because we put the starch in. So we have our patties and I have some sesame seeds here. I'm gonna just roll it a bit in sesame seeds. So it's gonna look like this. Well, almost ready. The falafels are made and crusted. The mushrooms are cooked, just finished. We're gonna make the sauce and the tomatoes. Now, for the tomatoes, we're gonna use this induction-ready wok by Becca. We're gonna put the cherry tomatoes in there. Salt, pepper, more salt, olive oil. So this is what we call a para confit. Confit is cooking in oil. And then a bit of our herbs. I have thyme and some dried oregano. And then you just leave this over the stove for about 20 minutes over very low heat, 20 to 30 minutes. That's why it's very important to have a very thick bottom so it doesn't burn. So this wok or saucepan by Becca, we'll make sure it cooks evenly and it won't burn the tomatoes, even if you cook it for 20-30 minutes over the stove. So after 20 minutes, it's gonna look like this. So this is what we want. That's the confit. Tomatoes cooked in herbs, salt, pepper, and then olive oil, that's it. But very beautiful flavors, very concentrated, and it's gonna give a nice flavor in our bowl. Okay, for our tahini sauce, we're gonna use garlic, because we love garlic. And then we're using this, this was the food processor a while ago. It's dual purpose. It could be a food processor or a blender. This is called the Desire for Brussels sprouts. And then tahini paste you can get from Santi's or Odeli. Asad also has sent tahini. Tahini is basically sesame paste. Used a lot in Mediterranean cooking. Very healthy also. Just like olive oil. The lemon juice. And then a bit of water. And then we blitz it. Add a bit more water to loosen it up. So this is the same sauce that's that you get from when you buy good shawarma. It's also called the white sauce, white garlic sauce. So some people mistake it for yogurt, but it's really tahini. Okay, that's it. So we have our sauce. And we have our quinoa, we have our cherry tomatoes, we have our mushrooms, we're going to take it out from the air fryer, our shimeji mushrooms that we roasted. Highly it's concentrated in flavors. So, shimeji mushrooms, the basket is free. Again, just a bit of oil, just to start things off for our falafel. So, oil the bottom, let's lay down our falafels. And then we're gonna put a bit of oil on the falafel also. We're gonna air fry this at 190, or maybe 180 for 10 minutes. So brush up olive oil on each. Then again, it started. So the thing with the air fryer is you want to give them space to breathe, and so that the color also is balanced all throughout the protein or the meat that you're putting in the air fryer. So we're gonna put this in. Okay, turn it on. Let's do 10 minutes first and check that out, and then do it 180 so we don't dry it out too fast. Let's start. We're finishing our bowl, the Mediterranean bowl. Our falafel is now cooked in the air fryer. This took about 15 minutes at 190, so this is how it looks. Nice patty. Now what we're going to do is place it on top of our cooked quinoa. Maybe 3 pieces per person is good enough. This here. And then our beautifully confit of tomatoes. It's going to give a nice acidity. And then use some of that oil. That oil is very flavorful. And then our mushrooms, our roasted mushrooms. And then of course our sauce. So we're gonna put a dollop of sauce in the middle. And then also just right on top of our falafels. Season it a bit with salt over the top, just to make sure that it has seasoning and a bunch of chopped cilantro. right over there, sort of for some freshness. Again, just a bit of oil, finish it. There we have it, our falafel bowl made of falafels, quinoa, and our vegetables. So we made two beautiful recipes today. One is a Mediterranean falafel bowl. The other one is a salmon poke with different textures and flavors. Really, really delicious, but also very good for your body. We could have not made these things if we didn't use beautiful appliances also from Rustan's home. We have this Becca all stainless steel chef series that cooked our quinoa, our rice, our cherry tomatoes. Also, I want to thank Russell Hobbs to make our falafels even more healthier by not deep frying it, but instead air frying it in their new product line, this digital air fryer. Also, we processed our falafels in the food processor by Russell Hobbs, also made the tahini sauce for them. So thank you, Russell Hobbs and Becca. So if you want to see the recipes, it's posted on our Instagram. And if you're interested in any of the items that I used today, please contact us, contact your personal shoppers at Rustan's. They'll be more than happy to help you out. So I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.